So, let's talk about cross-validation. So let's build this up slowly. What we want to do is, we know that we can't just use the data and just train it and that's it. We need an idea of how good it's going to be with new data sets. So we need to sort of put some aside to test it so we can get what we call our test mean square error. And the first one that you can do is you can do what we call the validation set approach. So validation set approach, you take your data and you split it into a training set and a validation set. And then what you do is you train your model on the training, which in this case is the blue numbers, and then you go and test it on the orange numbers. And to give you an example, what we've got here is we've got some auto data from the package ISLR, and we do an initial split. And we can split that into based on MPG. And when we do the split, we get this object here. And what this object is doing is it's saying there's 392 observations, of which it's put 296 into what we call the analysis set or the training set, and 96 is left over to assess this. So that's our test data. That just sort of splits it. It's just got pointers to the data to say which goes in each one. And then to actually get the data out, we use the training and the testing. And what you could do with that then is we could do a simple linear regression. So here we set up our linear regression, we set the engine, and we've fitted, so our outcome is MPG, and our single predictor in this case is horsepower, and we've used the training data. Then what I do is I'll take my train, I'm gonna add a column where I'm gonna predict, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the yardstick doesn't have the mean square error. We use the root mean square error, which is just the square root of that, where the truth is the actual values of MPG, and here's what we predicted from our model, and we get an estimate of 4.88. So that is our train root mean square error. With the test, all we do now is we run exactly the same command, but this time I'm now fitting my model, which I created using the training data, for the testing data and have a look. And here's a good example of what we normally expect is that our mean square error and our root mean square error are larger for the test data than the training because the training can overfit. And if these were really, really small, that is if you found that the train was really, really small and the test was a lot larger, I'd be really worried about overfitting. That is, I am creating a model that is basically too good at fitting for the training data and not good for the others. So that's one quick way you could do it. You could split it into the train and the test. The problem you find is, first of all, this validation estimate of the test error rate can be highly variable, depending on how it's split. And of course, with this particular approach, you've put some data aside and you're never using it. And there's a way that we could do that. Now, in reality, what we're going to do is we're going to do a mix of these two methods. We're probably going to take our data, if it's big enough, split it into training and test, put the test aside. We'll see a lot of this in a lot of our analysis. And then we'll actually use the train and maybe look at cross-validation on the train for choosing hyperparameters. But you'll see a lot of that in the pracs. But anyway, let's think about how we can improve this. Well, the first one is what we call a leave one out cross-validation. So what you do this, you get your data, you rearrange its order if you want to, you don't have to, but what you do is you go and first of all you take out the very first observation and you're going to fit a model to all the rest of the data, and then what you're going to do is you're going to say, well, how good does that data do for the one I took out? Now I get to the second point. The second point I take out, I fit a model to the blue bit, and then I say, nice, I fitted my model, how good does it fit the orange? So every time we take out an observation, we fit with the rest, and then we compare and see how it does. So here's the actual procedure. We will remove an observation. We will fit the model to the remaining n minus one. We will calculate our mean square error for that observation, which will be the yi minus what we fit for that. And then we just take an average of that, and that will be our leave one out cross-validation estimate. That's a lot of calculations. If you think about it, you know, I've got to fit that model a whole n times. The nice thing is if you're doing linear regression, there's a quick shortcut. You can actually just fit the model once and you can get your cross-validation automatically. And here's the stuff for you. But what we often do is you often do what we call a k-fold cross-validation. So what you do is you take your data. First of all, you randomize the order, and then you go and get a block. You get your first block, which is the orange bit. You fit all your the stuff that's left over, the blue bit, you use to train your model. And then you take that model and you fit it to the orange bit as your test. So what we've got here is this is your training data. Here's your testing. This is your blue, is your training test. Train test. So every observation ends up being in a test once. So in this case, we've done it five times. So this would be a five-fold cross validation. So to recap, we partition our data into k parts. For each part, we fit the model on the other k minus one parts, and then we use that fitted model to predict for the part removed. So the mean square error, if we have our parts c1 up to ck, these will usually have about nk observations. You try and keep that about the same. I mean, obviously, if your number of observations can be divided by your fold, then it's fine. If not, you might get one that's slightly larger or smaller than the other. So then what we do is we go and we fit our model to the remaining data. Then all the bits in our block that we've taken out, we take that minus it's fitted. Remember, this was fitted on the rest of the data. Square it and work out the average. And then we just work out a weighted average to take out into account there might be different sizes. And this will be our cross-validation mean square error for when we have a k-fold. And in the example before, we had five. So let's actually see how we do this in reality in tidy models. And this is probably the first time where tidy models really starts to pay dividends because it's so nice to do. So first of all, we've got a function called vfoldcv. You give it its data. You say how many folds you want. In this case, we want five. And you can also say, when you split it on some outcome. So they're reasonably equal when it comes to that outcome. And what you can see is it creates us what we call a nested data frame. So in this structure, this column is just a normal column. But this actually is a list. This is actually going to split it such that you have altogether 312 in your training and 18 in your testing. 313 in your training, 79. So it's done all the splitting for you. As far as this is concerned, it's just a 5x2, but this entry here is a whole list. So it's actually a substructure contained within it. So next we're going to create our recipe. So in this recipe, we're not going to do many steps. We're just going to set our MPG as our outcome, our horsepower as our predictor. We say where it is so it can go and look at it. So we've got a nice simple recipe. I'm not doing any steps. I'm not doing any juicing or baking, just very simple. And we'll set up a model. And our model, we're going to do a linear regression using LM. And now we're going to introduce something new. We're going to introduce a workflow. A workflow is just a structure for putting recipes and models together. So I create a blank workflow with the workflow command. I then add my recipe, I add my model. And now when I look at it, we've got this big structure that says, here's your recipe, here's any preprocessor, there's no steps in this, and here's your model. So workflow is a way of putting your recipe, your model. You can even put, if you want to, if your recipe didn't have an outcome, and you can put in a formula there as well. But now it's as simple as using the fit resamples. Here's our workflow, here's our cross-validation data, that's it. That is the entirety of cross-validation. Now at the moment you're sort of like going, so what? Before tidy models, you would have to hand code this using for loops and maps and all the stuff. The fact you can now do this in a single command is just amazing. And it suddenly means that tidy models pays for itself. Because now, if I want to get our information, I just take that data and I go collect metrics and it spits out. Here's my root mean squared, here's the mean, here's the standard error, here's the N. I can even get RSQ. And I could put in other metrics for this. I could do lots of cross validation metrics. And what it's doing is for each of those groups, it's doing that calculation. It's fitting, it's finding your root mean square error, and then it's taking a weighted average of that. Let's see it actually in action. Let's break down. So if I take our resamples, I can actually get the metrics, that is the root mean square and the R squared, for the first cross validation one. So this is me just getting the first one. And you can see that it's 4.31. So how did it get that 4.31? Well, what it did is it went to your splits, it grabbed the first one, and it grabbed out the analysis. So this is going to be your training data set. So I'll call this train one. Then I can also go to that first split, that first cross-validation split, and I can get out my test data, and I'll call this test one. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and fit a model to that training data. Then I'm going to use that to predict my test data, and then I'm going to calculate the root mean squared error for that. And there's your 4.31. So it's doing that for every single fold under the hood. It's going, it's grabbing the training data, it's fitting your model, it's getting that model, then it's going to the testing data, it's predicting for that testing data, and then it's looking at the difference between your testing data and what it predicts from that model. It then takes all them estimators and it puts them together, and it will calculate summaries for that with things like the average of them all and the standard error and how many there is. And it will do it for almost any metric. At this point, you're not impressed. You're sort of sitting there going, Jono, like, so what? That's like a couple of commands. If you really want to understand how good this is, go hand code this. That will probably be an hour of your life, if you're good, gone, which now you can do in a single command. So what do we do? Well, validation, so where you just take your data, you split it into a test and a train, tends to overestimate the test mean square error. Believe it or not, cross-validation seems to give unbiased estimates of the test mean square error. Well, the k-fold is between the two, but at the same time, the leave one out cross-validation has a higher variance than the k-fold cross-validation, as often your mean squares are highly positively correlated. So what do we often do in reality? Well, the general approach is you take your data, hopefully it's big enough, you split it. You take some that you keep aside as a final test, so you put that aside. Then you take the rest of the data and you will use that to train your models. And often with your models, when you're training them, you will actually do a cross-validation on the training. And you can use that to tune things like tuning parameters, which we'll get to later, especially when we start things like ridge regression. And I'll show you how to do all that. But you use that to basically tune your model as best you can. Then once you finish that, you can also test your cross-validation mean square error with that. But finally, to sort of have a last estimate of how good it is, you then take that final model you get and you go and apply it to that original test data. So often in reality, we do a mixture between the validation approach for that final test. And then once we've got our training data within the training, we use cross-validation within that to help tune our models. And we'll see lots of examples of this, so hopefully it'll become more obvious as we go on. What about classification problems? Well, now instead of mean square error, we will often do various metrics, and the classic one is we just do an error rate, where basically our error rate is how many times do you just count the number of times you got it wrong. So you might have said, look, this is a success. Your model predicts, your model predicts a success. In reality, it's a failure. That would be an error. Or maybe in a multiple level classification, maybe you predicted a cat, the truth was dog, that's an error. But we'll see more sort of misclassification errors as we go along. Okay, so that's an introduction to cross-validation. Theoretically, it's hard to get your head around. You'll see a lot more examples in the prax than that. But the main thing to remember is you're taking your data and you're splitting it. And often you split it so you have some test data to come back to. And often with cross-validation, what we're doing is we're taking it and we're splitting and repeating that process of train, test, train, test, train, test. If in doubt, go back and look at the pictures. Okay, see you next time.